I want to compare and contrast the behavior of five-membered and six-membered rings in this mode of reactivity in which the pi system serves as the nucleophile, the electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions like we were considering in the previous webcast, but now with the five-membered heteroaromatics. We'll take as our five-membered ring our prototypical reaction, the reaction of thiophene, that system there, with acetyl nitrate. Acetyl nitrate is just a good source of an electrophilic nitronium cation, but it's going to react in a slightly different mode of reactivity. Two things to note. First of all, the reaction takes place at a very low temperature, minus 10 degrees C. Obviously, this is much accelerated compared to the previous case of the six-membered ring. And the second thing to note is that the mode of substitution takes place in this position, the so-called 2 position. In the 2 position, that hydrogen atom is going to be displaced. So this is carbon 2 of thiophene, and we'll call that carbon 3 of thiophene. It's the carbon 2, its hydrogen, that undergoes substitution with the nitro group. There's a couple of ways we could understand why the substitution takes place at C2 rather than C3. One thing that we might do is to do a Schmo calculation and look at the highest occupied molecular orbital, and we'd find that the greatest coefficient of the highest occupied molecular orbital is going to be on C2. That's one thing. Another way we might anticipate this reactivity is to compare the two different types of intermediates that form by attack at C2 and by attack at C3. Let me outline that for you, and what I would encourage you to do while you're listening to this is to make a reaction coordinate diagram and compare the reaction pathway for C2 attack versus C3 attack. C2 attack involves three resonance contributors, whereas C3 attack only involves two. This is an pi to sigma star type interaction. We're going to break the sigma bond between nitrogen and oxygen in acetyl nitrate, and we'll end up making a new carbon-nitrogen bond. This intermediate is a carbocation intermediate that is delocalized onto those positions in the ring as well as on the sulfur atom. And so an N to A type interaction, resonance interaction, gives us three resonance contributors, one of which, the best one, is the last one because it has an octet of electrons on every atom. Attack at C3 provides us with a less stable intermediate. That less stable intermediate only has two resonance contributors, one of which is, again, having a positive charge on sulfur, an octet of electrons on every atom. But you can see that we have less delocalization of that positive charge. The intermediate that results from attack at C2 is more stable. The reaction pathway proceeds through a transition state to the C2 attack that's lower in energy than the C3 attack. That pathway, the C2 pathway, is faster than the C3. Why the enhanced reactivity? We just explained the regioselectivity, but why the enhanced reactivity? And that has to do with the highest occupied molecular orbital energy level being elevated. The higher the energy of the HOMO, the more nucleophilic is that pair of electrons. And so that's one reason. So there's really two reasons why benzene of these four is the least reactive toward electrophilic aromatic substitution. So the first thing that I've already mentioned is this idea down here where the pi electrons are raised up in energy. They're more nucleophilic than the benzene ring pair of electrons. And if you did a Schmo calculation, you would in fact see that those electrons in the HOMO of the thiophene ring or the other five-membered heteroaromatics are higher in energy than is benzene. But the other thing to note is that the transition state and the intermediate that results is more stable. And the main reason for that is that intermediate can be drawn with a complete octet on every single atom. Here's one resonance contributor, and that's the carbocation, but we have, don't forget, we have this non-bonding pair of electrons that can do an N to A or an N to pi star type donation and provide us with an intermediate, a resonance contributor of that intermediate that has an octet of electrons on every atom. You cannot find that in the case of benzene. All you have is open shell carbocations. So the intermediate is more stable, and because the transition state is going to resemble the intermediate, the pathway is going to be lower. So we have two things going for us. The energy is raised, the energy of that highest occupied molecular orbital is raised, and the transition state is lowered, and that's what makes these heteroaromatics more reactive than benzene. All right, let's take a look at the imidazole very quickly and say that if we have an N2 nitrogen in the ring, we're going to undergo deactivation for the reasons that we encountered with pyridine. We're going to first do acid-base chemistry, and that's going to facilitate lowering that HOMO, making that pi system much less reactive. Those pi electrons, now being part of a positively charged ring, are no longer very reactive. And so the presence of an N2 nitrogen in a molecule like imidazole make it very unfavorable toward electrophilic aromatic substitution, in which the pi system acts as a nucleophile.